into the standing. We're gonna take 8 breaths in each pose. Continue doing your standing postures and make sure that you're focusing on taking 8 breaths in each posture, lengthening the back of your neck, because in the neck we have sympathetic, parasympathetic nervous system, and whenever we are in a back bend position, we are compressing the sympathetic nervous system, meaning that we are firing it up and we're in a fight or flight mode. If we are extending the neck, then that means we're in a parasympathetic state, which is what we want to practice. So in all these postures, you want to lengthen the neck, trikonasana. You don't want to throw your head back, you want to keep the neck long. So I want you to do all the standing postures, breathing 8 breaths at a time. When you get to Uttanasana, Padmasana, so still the standing postures but moving into the balances, I want you to just take 5 breaths in each movement. And then we're gonna go into the seated. In the seated postures, the same thing. I'm gonna take the vinyasas out and we're gonna chunk the postures into sets. And the whole focus is again that you don't extend your chin forward, but you let your head come down towards your legs so that the back of your neck is in extension, is in relaxation mode. It's not being compressed. Purvottanasana, coming down, stay here, 5 breaths or 8 breaths. Then we're going to chunk together the Janushirshasanas, 3 of them, stay here, 5 or 8 breaths. Then we're going to chunk together, half lotus and triang, chunk them together, 5 or 8 breaths. Janushirshasanas, chunk them together, 5 or 8 breaths. Marichasana A through Marichasana D, so 4 Marichasanas, chunk them together, 5 or 8 breaths. Dandasana, take Navasana with the hands behind the back, the thighs, or here. Only 5 breaths per posture. In between postures, taking 5 breaths right here with the back of the neck lengthening. Stop here. We're gonna do it to back bending. We're gonna go down and we're just gonna do a half wheel, 8 breaths, coming down, 5 breaths, half wheel, 8 breaths, coming down, 5 breaths. If you want to do a full wheel, you can just take 5 long breaths, looking at the tip of your nose the whole time. Then you're gonna roll up and you're gonna forward bend for 20 breaths. And then you'll come up and you'll do your finishing. The whole idea of the finishing is that you extend the breath. The finishing postures are the postures that help us to extend the nervous system. So they're meant to kick in the parasympathetic nervous system. So again, take long, deep breaths. You can take extra breaths in Halasana, Karnapidasana, and Shirshasana. You can take 20 breaths, 25 breaths. Come down, and now when we get to the breathing, We're going to extend the breath, try to make that count of the breath that we saw in the other video, so there's an extension of the breathing. We're going to do together three breathing exercises that you'll finish your practice with. And again, this is just a video for you to watch before you practice, so you know how to move. So I'm assuming that you've done your finishing breathing sequence. You have Baddha Padmasana, Yoga Mudra, then you come up, you do Padmasana breathing, 10 breaths. Now you're going to take your thumb holding the right nostril, ring finger and pinky stay up, and you're going to block the left nostril with your ring finger, not your pinky. So again, inhaling through the nose. Exhale. So we're going to start with 10 breaths here. Inhale. Exhale. In your own practice, you're going to do that 5 more times, which adds up to 10. This is just an intro to it. From here, you move into Nadi Shodhana, which is you put your ring finger and pinky together, put down the index and middle finger. You're going to use your thumb to block off the right nostril and use your ring finger to block off the left nostril. So we're going to start by blocking off the right, inhale through your left, block the left, exhale to the right. Block the right, inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Close right, inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Close right, inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Close right, inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Now inhale right, exhale left, close left, inhale right, close right, exhale left. Close left, inhale right. Close right, exhale left. Close left, inhale right. Close right, exhale left. Close left, inhale right. Close right, exhale left.
So it's 5, inhaling through the right, exhaling through the left.
and then 5, inhaling through the right, exhaling through the left. You take 5 breaths here. And then one more breathing practice to add into your practice is you're gonna sit like this. You can sit in lotus, take your hands behind you, lift your chest, let your head either fall back or hold it up. And take 5 deep breaths into your chest. I like to keep my head up, again for the same idea of not crunching the back of my neck, but keeping it in extension. So these 2 last breaths that you're going to add into your closing sequence, Nadi Shodhana and this extension of the chest, are really great pranayama practices to add into your routine before eating a meal. It'll calm your nervous system and stretch your esophagus and your diaphragm, your stomach, so that you can begin to prepare your body to digest, to take in food, right? You can begin to stimulate the Agni, and you can calm down the nervous system so that when it's going to eat, it's not in fight or flight mode, which will create agitation and will create maybe you going to the bathroom and throwing up afterwards. It will allow you to settle and to be ready to welcome your food in and have a meal and be nourished by it. You can also do this breathing anytime throughout the day where you feel like you're very agitated and you're going into a mode of like judgment. I like to do it before going to bed. It's also a nice way to just unwind, relax, lay down. So the essentials of this practice that I just kind of outlined is that you stretch the breath, you make less effort, and you focus on putting your attention on your drishti and on extending the breath. Right? If it's too much to go so slowly, then just extend the breath and take 5 breaths instead of 8, but just make the commitment to really be present to your breathing and to your drishti points. I hope you put this into practice. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me. And again, sign up to my newsletter, bibilorenzetti.com, and be in touch. I look forward to meeting you perhaps on one of my retreats.